This man wasn't human, he was a god whose duty was to protect a family. Therefore, no one dared to threaten this family. Although this old man was about to die, the king of hell couldn't do anything else, and sent someone to take his soul away. Suddenly, this god appeared to stop them. He didn't say anything but rushed to punch and kick. These two basically couldn't beat him. So they were beaten badly, and had to beg for forgiveness. But unexpectedly, this god recognized them. Because this god was also a messenger of hell before. Because the two of them had their memories erased, they didn't recognize him. The god said the old man's last wish was to see his grandson go to school. Waiting until the old man had fulfilled his wish, then they could take him away. So they had to agree. The reason why they accepted the mission to escort this soul was that they had a contract with the king of hell before. They wanted to protect a person in hell. Because he was killed unjustly, he was actually an innocent person. And they had to prove it. By doing so, he would have a chance to reincarnate in another life. The king of hell asked to take the old man's soul as a contract condition. Actually, this god's mission was to protect a family so he couldn't hit mortals. The next day, there was a group of people rushing in. They were gangsters and they came to force this family to move out. Seeing this, this god stood up to stop them, but was pushed down. Although this god had a great power, he lost all his strength when touched by a human. Taking that opportunity, he won and Duck Chung, who came from hell, said, "We can help you, but you have to tell us who we were in our previous lives." Seeing that the old man and the boy were threatened, this god had to agree. He won and Duck Chung then helped the god defeat the gangsters. After that, this god brought this guy back to his memories of thousands of years ago. It turned out that 1,000 years ago, he was a mighty warrior of the Goryeo army, and was tasked with guarding the border. At that time, the Jurchen army was very scared just hearing his name. Because he wore a white wolf fur scarf, people called him White Wolf. At this time, the messenger Gang Rim also began to talk about his past. It turned out that Gang Rim's father was the leader of the Goryeo army. Gang Rim was often led to battle by his father. Because his father wanted him to take on his career. That day, they saw a child taken prisoner. However, the general didn't kill the boy. He used his compassion and tolerance to adopt that boy. However, Gang Rim felt unhappy because he had to see his father's love shared with another child. After that, his younger brother learned a lot of martial arts. He even defeated Gang Rim. Because of that, Gang Rim was extremely resentful. Once, Gang Rim overheard that his father wanted to give all military power to his younger brother. He was extremely angry. Really, he couldn't accept this. After that, the god continued to tell the story of the girl's life. He took the girl back 1,000 years ago. Once when she was out looking for food, she encountered a large tiger. The tiger rushed at her and was about to eat her. Suddenly, there was an arrow shot. That was White Wolf. He killed the tiger, and then he went to the hideout of the Jurchens. But when he opened the door, he saw only children who were scared. And they knelt begging him to spare their lives. After that, he released the children, and even shared the food with them. Duck Chung said that this girl, and the children were the people of the Jurchens tribe. Their relatives were killed by a Goryeo soldier. And people called him White Wolf. However, she didn't know that the killer was in front of her. It turned out that 1,000 years ago, he one was the one who killed Duck Chung's family. The two of them later erased all their animosity. Because the hell's rule was that if one of them hadn't received the other's forgiveness, they would forever be considered criminals. However, was this true? After that, he one taught Duck Chung how to survive to find peace. The cold winter had come and the famine had also begun. Although the army's food was gradually running out, he one still stole food to bring to the children. However, for the Goryeo army, this action was considered treason. Finally, one day, the superiors found out and immediately called he one over. And asked him to tell the current whereabouts of the children. If not, they would throw his body to the wolves. However, he one was determined not to say. So he and his subordinates were thrown into the deep forest and eaten by wolves. The wolves had already surrounded them so they could only fight back with their legs. Finally, relying on his superior martial arts, he was able to escape from the wolves. He one used ropes to drag his subordinates and tried to walk in the blizzard. And they also reached the children's place. Unexpectedly, at this moment, the superiors also chased over. Seeing this, he one told Duck Chung to immediately run away. But when Duck Chung was about to leave, he pulled her hand again. And said the things he was hiding. "I'm really sorry." Then he took out a white scarf and put it around her neck. Duck Chung finally understood that her parents were killed by He Won. He wanted to ask for forgiveness from Duck Chung. After that, Duck Chung hugged He Won tightly. The girl forgave his sins. And Duck Chung ran away while crying. At this moment, the soldier came over. He was Min Kyu. He Won asked the god if he was killed by Min Kyu. But the god suddenly stopped talking, and he just sighed. It turned out that the gangsters broke his earthly vase. So he was about to disappear. The god said, "There is no one in the world who is completely evil. Don't rush to resent others. Try to give them a chance to confess." He-won tried to ask, but the god gradually disappeared. He-won was very angry, and even wrote Min-kyu's name in the dead man's name book. When going to Hell's Gate, Gang-rim remembered his past. He finally killed his younger brother mercilessly. However, that younger brother was He-won. He-won also recognized the person who killed him was Gang-rim. Gang-rim did that because of his father's injustice, and also because of his selfishness. At that moment, Duk-chung also stabbed him with a knife. After that, Gang-rim took out his sword, so the three of them fell together. It turned out that Duk-chung and He-won were both killed by Gang-rim. And then their memory had been erased. Back to the present. The rookie who murdered Hong-suk was summoned to hell. This rookie said that his gun was stolen, so he accidentally shot Hong-suk. However, Gang-rim saw the whole thing. It turned out that the superior asked the rookie to bury Hong-suk. Although they saw that Hong-suk was still alive, Hong-suk died because of their cruelty. Gang-rim interrogated him. "Did you bury Hong-suk when he was still alive?" However, this rookie started convulsing. If he didn't get back to Earth in time, he might lose his life. His memories with Hong-suk were slowly coming back. He still didn't confess, then his soul gradually disappeared. At this time, he also died on Earth. The soldier of hell said this was his destiny. Because the witness didn't give clear evidence. After that, Gang-rim sent the lieutenant's soul to hell for questioning. "Did you bury Hong-suk when he was still alive?" The lieutenant was so scared that he couldn't say anything. Gang-rim then told the story of his past life. After Gang-rim, Duk-chung and He-won died and went to hell. The king of hell came over to them. "You killed two people, so your sins are unforgivable," he said. "Gang-rim, your memories will be kept forever. You'll have to bring the two of them. Within 1,000 years, you must find 49 innocent souls, then you can be reincarnated. This is your punishment." Thousands of years had passed, Gang-rim had to endure pain and torment. Suddenly, the stone gate was opened. At this moment, hellfire was surrounding Hong-suk. And the lieutenant had to make a choice. One was that he had to confess his crime. Or he would have to hide this forever. After that, Gang-rim revealed a secret that his father didn't die in battle. Actually, he had killed his father. At that time, Gang-rim saw that his father's hand was still moving, but didn't come to save him. He resented his father for treating him unfairly. By the time he felt extremely regretful, and ran over, but it was too late. His father was dead. Because those crimes had caused him pain for thousands of years. At this time, the King of Hell revealed a shocking secret. It turned out he was Gang-rim's biological father. At that time, he pretended to be the King of Hell to cover his pain. At this time, the lieutenant also agreed to tell the truth. Finally, he admitted he killed Hong-suk. Hong-suk was killed unjustly. Therefore, all sins had been forgiven. Hong-suk was able to reincarnate. The lieutenant also felt less guilty. He-won and Duk-chung also forgave Gang-rim. In the end, the King of Hell allowed this old man to continue living until his grandson finished elementary school. This was a story about mistakes and forgiveness. Actually, no one in the world is completely bad, only those who accidentally make mistakes. Smile and forgive if they sincerely admit their mistake. The movie comes here. See you on the next movies.